short by Bob Wiley.
Wiley.
Wiley. Exterior, convenience store, parking lot, night. AC vents under a sodium light. Gas pumps look lonely. Light from inside the C store projects through the wide front windows cluttered with sales signs. In front, a single car, a slick red Camaro. In the shadows, an old dark pickup is backed into a stall. A logo illuminates the cab, and we can make out the figure of a man. Interior, pickup, night. Mac, late 20s, flannel shirt, and two-day-old beard pounds down the remainder of a beer. His troubled and melancholy eyes are fixated on the C-store. Without a look back, he tosses the can into the bed through the open cab window. He's had practice. Mac wipes his mouth with the shirt sleeve and turns the radio up, a twanging country tune, still eyeing the store. Mac's POV. A preppy boy leans on the counter and chats it up with a cute, dark-haired girl behind the counter. This is Brooke, 20s. Brooke laughs and flips her hair back. Preppy boy grabs a pen and writes down on his hand as Brooke mouths a number. Interior, pickup. Matt grabs a beer from his 12-pack box. Laying on the seat next to the 12-pack is a pistol. Matt pops open the can. He guzzles a long drink and slams his hand against the steering wheel. Max POV. Preppy boy steps to the front door. As he leans against the door, he says something to Brooke. She laughs, he smiles. Preppy boy giddily hops into the Camaro, fires it up, and streaks it away. Tail lights quickly fade into the night. Empty parking lot. Crickets chirp. Interior, pickup. Mac takes a quick swig, then sits down the can. He quickly pulls down the visor and looks into the mirror. Mac fiddles with his hair and wipes his eyes with his mouth. He forces a smile. He looks more like an addict than a suitor. He flips up the visor. Inhale. Exhale. Mac grabs the pistol and opens the truck door. Cell phone rings. Mac fumbles with the phone on the dash. It's Brooke. He quickly answers.
Hey!
Are you insane? You think I can't see you?
Listen, Kim.
Leave or I'm calling 911. You know what'll happen if I call the cops again. Leave. Now.
Click. Mac fumes and wings the phone. It smashes against the floorboard. He downs the rest of the beer and slams the can into the console. He swiftly grabs the pistol, pushes open the truck door, and slides 1 foot onto the pavement. Loud womp. Mac's POV. An older gray Corolla bounces as it clips the curb entering the parking lot. Womp. The car hops as the back tire also smacks the curb. The Corolla meanders through the lot and rocks to a stop, taking up 2 spaces. Interior, pickup. Max slinks back into the truck and slams the door shut. He lays the pistol on the seat next to him.
God damn it.
Max POV. A disheveled and sad-looking blonde girl, 18, turns off her car. She sits there for a moment, staring zombie-like. Longer wipes her tears from her swollen, tired eyes. Door clicks open, and she slowly climbs out with a paper sack in hand. As she makes her way to the C-store's front door, she steadies herself against the car. The blonde girl wanders through the front door and surveys the C-store. Blonde girl mounts a question to Brooke. Brooke replies and points to the hallway. Blonde girl disappears into the hallway. Interior, pickup. Mac pops open another beer and sips it slowly. He turns up the radio. Max sees his phone, reaches over and picks it up off the floor. He evaluates the damage. He smacks the phone against his palm. The screen won't light up.
Why do you make me so fucking crazy?
Max winds up and fireballs the phone against the floor again. The screen shatters. He grabs the steering wheel with both hands and glares at Brooke.
I don't understand you.
Max POV. Long girl shuffles slowly past the counter with a cold vacant gaze. She's empty-handed, no paper bag. Brooke, concerned, mounts the question to the blonde girl, but no response. Blonde girl is in another world. Brooke mounts another question to the blonde girl and resignedly shakes her head as the blonde girl slips out the front door. The blonde girl stoically ambles to her car and pops into her seat. She pulls the front door shut and erupts into tears, convulsing against the steering wheel. Interior, pick up. hops out of the truck. Exterior, parking lot. Mac makes his way toward Longville's heart. He steps quickly. Mac approaches the Corolla and knuckle wraps the window.
You all right in there?
Get away.
Door locks. Click shut. The blonde girl fumbles with her keys. She jingles keys into the ignition and engine roars. She throws it into reverse. Tires squeal as the car jumps backward.
Hey, I didn't mean anything, just...
Blonde girl shifts it forward, peels away. Mac throws his hands up as the Corolla skids off into the parking lot and onto the street, heading south. Mac's POV. Throat frighteningly clutches to her cell phone. Though we can't hear her, she mouths...
What are you doing?
Exterior, parking lot. Mac shakes his head and waves off Brooke as he heads toward the truck. Mac stops forward. He spins around and determinedly makes his way toward the C-store entrance. Interior, C-store. Door dings as Mac steps in. Brooke has her cell phone to her ear.
Don't you come near me.
Mac doesn't look at Brooke. Instead, he peers down the hallway, sees a restroom sign.
You don't need to do that.
Mac clumps down the hallway and pauses in front of the women's door. Mac jingles the handle, and it opens, and he slides in. Interior, C-store, restroom. Light flickers as he surveys the room. Trash can, wadded up paper sack. Mac picks up the sack and cautiously opens it.
What are you doing in there? The cops are on their way.
He pulls out a small box. Mac's POV, EPT pregnancy test. Interior, C-store, restroom. Mac tosses the box into the trash can and rummages around the sack some more. He pulls out a test strip. It's a plus. A knowing and concerned little grunt comes from Mac. Mac tosses the sack and test strip into the trash can.
I mean it, Mac.
Mac stops at the counter.
You know that girl?
Girl, are you serious? You have a problem.
Do you know her?
Some high school girl. I don't know. Why do you care? You've got to leave.
Brooke waves the phone in his face. Exterior, convenience store, parking lot. Mac steps onto the sidewalk and looks off in the direction the blonde girl took. Moment of clarity. He grins like he just solved an algebra problem. Interior, C-store. Mac steps inside the door. Brooke has her cell phone to her ear.
I mean it, Mac. Stay away.
I gotcha. You can cancel the cops. Goodbye, Brooke.
Mac flings the door open in his phone. Brooke slowly pulls the phone down from her ear, and we see that no number was dialed.